Jupiter, Florida, an ocean oasis 20 minutes north of Palm Beach, is home to many of golf's elite players. We went to see Jesper Parnevik, who's back on the PGA Tour after a serious back injury had threatened retirement.
Hello. Welcome to my house in Jupiter, Florida. Come on in, I'll show you around.
Well, I came over here in the mid-80s, just visiting a friend of mine. So when I needed a kind of winter place to practice before the European Tour started and all that, it was a natural place for me to get an apartment down here. And it evolved into buying a house and so on, and in the end, building a house.
Like every morning, I'm going to start a day with a nice workout.
Come on down to the gym.
I've been known for hitting a lot of golf balls, first of all. I'm always in the searching mode, so I hit a lot of golf balls on the range and so on. And so I've worn out both my hips, so I've hit surgery on both sides. And after they did my second hip, it didn't quite get that well or recovered as the way I wanted to. And so I went in for a new test, and that's when the CAT scan recovered. I have a fractured L5.
Well, here's the gym. This is where I tried to rehab my back. It's been a very slow process. I mean, I've worked out a lot before I had my injuries, but now it's pretty much whatever it takes.
Feels relatively loose. I mean, I can't get it as loose as it was used to be, but when it feels swingable, you know, I'm hitting great shots and I'm playing well and so on, and then of course, it stiffens up sometimes after a while, and then if you're going to see shots that you didn't think was possible, I can hit it sideways.
Jesper was twice runner-up at the Open Championship in the 90s, but he regards playing in the Ryder Cup as his career highlight.
The feelings you have coming down the stretch in a major or whatever, you have pretty much on every hole in the Ryder Cup. And it's electric like you've never seen before. And I mean, how often do you see guys or golfers who can be semi-boring sometimes, high-fiving and jumping and screaming on the first hole. So that pretty much sums it up right there.
Always an eccentric character, Jesper earned the nickname Spaceman on tour, fitting for a man from the town of Jupiter.
That whole thing, because I was also first pretty much on the European Tour or any tour, you know, I started doing yoga, doing all those stuff that looked or was very strange stuff back then, you know, that the golfer would do yoga. I've tried some weird stuff, I don't get me wrong as well, but a little bit more normal these days, I would say.
Enjoy.
Not sure about the color. While injury forced him out of the game he loves, Jesper still kept busy off the course.
Not bad. So being home now for almost a year, it's been different, a lot of fun. So I've been like a soccer mom, you know, doing all that, going to soccer games.
I'm actually one of the few lucky guys in the world that has a bigger closet than their wife.
With close friend and designer Johan Lindeberg, the ever-stylish Swede has become a leading light in golf fashion.
And Johan Lindeberg called me up, you know, and just said, we need to change this because I think this is... Golf used to be such a fashionable sport. Look back at Arnold Palmer and those guys, how they dressed. They were so cool and this and that. And so, you know, we started with, you know, trimmer fit, better fit on the shirts, pants, and everything. And now you see the whole golfing world. I mean, it's a different scene out there now than it was 20 years ago, I tell you.
Well, we're here at one of the originals, actually.
These ones I played with it at the Bob Hope Classic for the first time. And they were so tight, I could not bend down to get the ball out of the cup after I hold the putt. So I had to ask my caddy to take the ball out because I didn't want something to crack in the back here.
Jesper does seem to be back to his old self, particularly after making the cut in his opening two tournaments of 2011.
Very ecstatic about that and happily surprised, actually. And so, I mean, it's getting better, and I just would like to get a few shots better every round, you know, so you won't. All of a sudden, you're going to be back there in the hunt again, because that's the feeling where I want, the feeling I'm searching about, me having a chance on back nine on Sunday again.
Maybe that's where I need to reboost my career again. Go back to the old flip-up pad.
No matter which hat the stylish 46-year-old is wearing, we hope to see the trailblazing Swede on the course for many more years. With 14 professional wins worldwide, we aren't counting him out yet. Number 15 could be just around the corner.
See you on the Plumber courses this summer. Have a good time and goodbye.